Welcome to the Sisters Entertainment Showcase. We have our author showcase tonight with Miss Terry Lyles. Welcome to the showcase.
Well, how you doing, Miss Carter? Hello, everybody.
I'm doing well. Thank you so much. So tell us about your novel of short stories and poetry titled Exposed. Did I get that correct?
You got it right. It's Exposed. That's my ninth book, and the book is just like the title, man. You know, I am so transparent about everything that I do. When you see the word exposed, you know what that means. So my objective is to put stuff out there on Front Street, things that you don't want to talk about. You talk about it in secret. I'm going to pull the covers back. I'm going to put you out there, and I'm going to talk about it.
Oh, I like that.
Yes, baby.
So what was the inspiration behind you choosing that particular title?
Well, every book that I have wrote, the title is kind of like self-explanatory. From Brown Bag Poetry, which was the first one, and on the cover of that book, you got a picture of a lady coming out of a brown paper bag. Because in that book, it had a lot of sexual explicit stuff in it. And you know, in the mail, when you get sexual stuff, it was always in brown paper. So the lady that was coming out of it, she had different shades of color. You know, she was a light-skinned woman, a dark-skinned woman, all different shades on her body. You know, and so, you know, and guys call women your old bag. So, you know, I was like jumping out with everything, X-rated included. That was my baby.
Oh, wow. That is truly awesome. So is there a message that you want your audience to walk away after they've picked up your novel Exposed? Is there a message you're trying to get them to walk away with?
Well, the message that I'm trying to get everybody to walk away with, and I don't care whether it's book Exposed or the first one or all the way through, is just that, you know something? It's nothing special about you and things that you have gone through, whether it's embarrassing or whatever. Trust and believe we have gone through it too. Sometimes, you know, we put a smile on our face, but we all got a tail and we all got some skeletons. Some people's closets are harder to close and some are not. But the thing is, I want people to understand that, you know, your wounds are not unique. So if you get out of your own way and start your healing process and stop beating yourself up and thinking that you don't have any worth, that ain't true. Just keep it real, man. You know, learn from your mistakes, keep it moving, and, you know, just feel like, you know, God got this, man. Don't listen to knucklehead people telling you that you ain't good enough or you are a knucklehead or you messed up. My books are so real and so transparent that you think I'm looking through your window at your house, because what you done, trust me, I done probably done it or known somebody else who have done it. And, you know, it's like a cycle that we go through. Everybody, we have been through some stuff or exposed to some stuff. So the main thing is, don't beat yourself up. Stop putting yourself down. Love yourself first, you know, and just move on, because, you know, the hurt will subside over time. Just don't keep thinking that you're a failure or you stupid or you didn't make the right choices, because nobody makes all the right choices. You know, sometimes we have a support system to help us get through it, but at the end of the day, you know, take it to the Lord in prayer, and when you take it to him, leave it there. Don't sit there and take it to him and then pick it back up and bring it back and cry and whine about it. Whatever you do, when you take a problem to the Lord, trust with me, what I'll tell you. Don't stress out about it. Don't keep reliving it. Just give it to God and keep moving. He will fix it.
Absolutely. Amen.
That's right, my sister. I'm a living and walking testimony. You don't know, but ask somebody.
Oh, that is beautiful. Who are some of your influences in literature that inspired you to write?
Okay, the one main thing that inspired me was in 2008. I was listening to Steve Harvey on the radio show, and he was talking about how he had haters because of his wealth and because what he was doing with his life. And he said, you know something, don't get mad at me, because, you know, you got a talent as well. Take your talent and use it, you know, because we all got the same 24 hours a day. And what I found out was that, you know, a lot of times people like myself, we didn't know what our talent was, because I was saying to myself, I said, he's right. I said, now, what is my talent? And, you know, I said, Lord, what is my talent? Now, I did not hear any audio voice or anything, but in my spirit, it was so strong. I thought it was like God was telling me, well, shoot, you run your mouth all the time. Won't you write it down? And then, boom, I said, well, spitting out of me, I wrote a book in 30 days. Hello.
All right.
And I put everything in there. I put in there from, you know, medical issues, people on drugs, people messing up, locked up, people masturbating. I didn't know what not to put in there. I put it all in there. And the main reason I did that is because I had some colorful friends. Some of my friends are transgender. Some are normal. You know, I got colorful friends, you know. And I include their story in my book, because one thing people have found out about me is that, you know, a lot of people think, for real, Ms. Carter, that they don't feel like they are good enough to have God care about them. And I've done some things. You know, I ain't got no shame in my game, man. You know, used to sell drugs, you know, used to swing, you know. You know, I got some scars, you know, and I'm the preacher's kid, you know. And I just got when I went to California. So I tell people, you know, hey, you know, I ran to California to hide from the eyes of the people who knew me. But because I went through all these things that I went through, I found out at the end of the day, God still loved me, and he had my back. I even had this crazy guy. Now, this is really crazy. This guy took and glued the door frame so I couldn't open the door from inside the house, broke the phone up like a mobile. Now, I'm two floors up now. You know, I'm a QE on duty, but, you know, I ain't into all that physical stuff, jumping out of windows. But, I jumped out that window through some bushes. I had thistles and stuff in my head. I ran to my car. The door lock was missing. The battery was gone. The wires was gone. The steering wheel was off.
Oh,
my God. You know, and then I heard him coming back on his motorcycle. So I'm hiding right behind him out in the bush. And when he went to the house, I ran the other way. I said, oh, Lord, you know, that was a close call, because he was a nut. But it goes to show you, it just goes to show you, God kept me. In spite of all the things I've done, you know, he kept me. And what people relate to with me, they say, well, Dad, you know, she done did all this stuff, and she can go into church, and now she's a Bible school teacher. It gives them hope that there's nothing that they've done where they can't come to God in prayer, you know. So that's why I just put it on out there, you know. Been there, done that, you know. I'm going to show you my wounds so you know that I can relate to yours, you know. And, you know, we can talk about whatever you want to talk about, but before it's all over, I'm going to put Jesus up in it.
That's right. That's right. Yeah. We're all, you know, we're all human. We all make mistakes. And
yes,
we all have to answer to God one day. We all got to answer. So you did right. You did right. And I'm glad you put your mouth down to the pen, to the paper.
That's right, girl. My stuff is so clean. You say, woo, sister, woo, woo, woo. That's a Yes, and everybody loved my stuff. You know, even when I went to church, right? Now, this one chick, she bought my first book, which was explicitly sexual stuff. Now, I come out of church one day. She said, Sister Lyle. I said, what you want, baby? She said, can I have that book? Because somebody stole that book. Now, I'm saying, I got all these books. So I don't know what book she want. She said, you know that one, that nasty one. I said, girl, don't be ashamed. Because everybody up in this head, in this camp, they got one, too. So I gave her a book because this was a sale with me. But, you know, a lot of people said this was their favorite bathroom book. You know, hey, it's my mama's favorite book. She said, I might be old and a widower, but I still got feelings. So I just like, hey, keep it real.
Oh, Lord, have mercy on us. So how can our audience learn more about you and find you on social media?
Okay, well, they can go to www.terrylye.com, which is my personal website, and I'm on Facebook under Authoress Terry E. Lyle. I'm on Twitter under SweetFire01. I'm on LinkedIn under Authoress Terry E. Lyle. But I also have a radio show I do each and every Friday, and always looking for a guest to be on my show, and my show is called Unmasked, because, you know, I want the real scoop. I don't want to have no interview that's hoity-toity and bougie. That's not who I am. You're kicking it with your girlfriend when you come to my show. We're going to let it all hang out. You're going to tell your dirt, I'm going to tell someone mine, so you don't have to feel uncomfortable, okay? And you're going to call us at 303-956-8753, and we can talk about it.
All right now. You go ahead, my sister.
Yes, baby. You know, I'm a clown part-time. I should have did that and got some paid that way. But, you know, I'm just a good person to be around. You know, I got the love and compassion for everybody. You know, I've learned from my mistakes, and I'm trying to teach the young people not to go the way I went because, you know, this is my responsibility to teach the ones behind us. You know, and I just try to do it in a funny way because sometimes you just get tired of crying, and I'm sick and tired of crying. It's about, you know, getting strong and healthier and laughing about what you've been through because you ain't going to do that again.
All right. Amen.
Amen.
Well, thank you so much. You are such a pleasure to talk to. I love your spirit. And,
thank you, darling.
You are so welcome. I am going to tag you. I'll find you on Facebook and on social media, and I will tag you when we upload the interview. It will be an audio with a write-up, and I will include all of your social media so that our audience can find you.
I like that.
All right now. And plus, we have our newsletter coming out this week, so I am going to put you in our news blast so that everybody had an idea, like a little heads-up to my subscribers. Hey, you got your
girl. Thank you. I'm not sure that I'm single and looking, okay? Now, I am a cutie on duty, and, you know, people might say I'm fat. No, I'm not fat. I'm plus size to some, but I call myself thick and juicy. Hello.
Oh, my goodness. You is something else. Go ahead. I ain't mad at you.
All right, sis. It's been a pleasure being on your show. Thank you for the opportunity to hang out with you, and, you know, you're always welcome to come kick it with me.
I sure will keep that in mind. All right now. You have a beautiful evening.
You as well. Bye-bye.
All right. Bye-bye.